have y'all patent, so we'll see. We're gonna be going over rate of change today. So rate of change allows you to see the relationship between two quantities that are changing. Y'all might have seen the slope formula. We're finding the slope is right here, but the rate of change is the change in y and the change in x. It is also called the rise of a run. There are several names for it. You might want to write them down. This is the equation for finding the slope. It's y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. It's equal to, and this is the symbol for delta. So the rate of change is also called delta y over delta x. All you need is two pairs. Solve the first one using this equation. What is y2?
Two.
Two, yeah. And what was that going to be minus?
Four.
A negative 4, yeah, that's right. And that's going to be over what?
Negative 3 minus 5.
Yeah. Negative 3 minus 5. And what is that going to be equal to?
Negative 8.
It will be equal to negative 8, but we'll continue on, and that is 6 over negative 8. And what does that reduce down to? Where does it reduce? What does that reduce down to, y'all know? 6 over negative 8.
Negative
3/4. That's right. Negative 3/4. That is the first way to do it. The second way to do it, a little bit easier. It's called stack and subtract. You line up your ordered pairs, subtract y, subtract x's, and put y over x. So you have your ordered pairs right here. You take the first one. 2/4, stick the other one underneath it. And you subtract them. So you subtract your y's. You get 4 minus 3 is 1. And subtract your x's. 2 minus 5 is what?
Negative 3.
Negative 3. Now you put your y over your x. So that'd be 1 over negative 3. That doesn't reduce down anymore, and that's your answer. We're going to do the same thing with the other ordered pairs. What am I going to write here? Negative what? 2/5, and that's going to be over negative 1/4, and we're going to subtract those. A negative 2 minus a minus 1 would be a negative 2. Plus 1 is negative 1. 5 minus 4?
1.
Your y over your x, what is that going to be? 1 over negative 1, which is just negative 1. y'all don't get some of the information, just let me know and I'll backtrack. All right, I'm gonna do the first one again with y'all. What is this one gonna be?
103.
I'll subtract them, giving me -3, 1. Y over your X's is gonna be what? And does that reduce down anymore?
No.
Right, if y'all wanna attempt the next one there on the rock. Anyone have the answer? What you got?
-1/5.
Almost. It is 1/5. So we'll do it.
Wait, I meant 1/5. I didn't even put a negative sign on it.
3/5 minus -2/4. That's going to be 3 minus a minus 2 is 5. And that's 1. Y over X is 1/5. I'm going to try the next one here too. Anyone got the answer? What you got?
8/-1.
8/-1, which is just -8. So -2, 3, minus -1, -5. -2 minus a minus 1 is -1, 3 minus a minus 5 is 8. Y over X is 8/-1, which is -8. That's a really funny one today. And what about the last one? Anyone got an answer for that already? What you got? -2/3. Yeah, that'll work. -4/0, 2. Subtract them, -3/2. Y over X is 2/-3. Alright, we do all that because we're going to move into charts, as I believe what it's going to be on this quiz today. Y'all be given the chart, you got to figure out the order of pairs that you want, that it's asking you to find. What are the order of pairs in this chart? What's the X value? So that's the X value, this is the Y value, and it's asking to find the rate of change between 3 o'clock and 6 o'clock. So what's your two ordered pairs that you're going to use?
6 o'clock.
Yeah, and what will those ordered pairs be? So it's going to be 3 and 6, what's the Y values at those two times?
115 and 195.
Yeah. Yeah, we're gonna subtract those, and now that I'm looking at it, I wish I would have put the other one on top, just so we don't get negative numbers, so I'm gonna do that. Subtract your Y's, what do you get? Hey, that's right, and your X's is? 6 minus 3. Now you put your Y over your X. And this is 80 over 3. Now this is the rate of change between 3 o'clock and 6 o'clock. Your 3 is your time. And your 80 is your miles, your distance. So in 80 miles, you go, in 3 hours, you go 80 miles. Now it asks you to find the unit rate. So you want to find how many miles you go in 1 hour. So what do you need to do? Divide by what? Divide by 3. And if you divide by 3, what would you get? 26.6. And does that continue? 26.66666. And we're just going to round that. So what is it going to be? 26.7. And that is miles over 1 hour. Now it has to find the rate of change of the input and output table. They don't tell you what values you use or which ones should you use. First two don't hurt, or you could use any single one of these. So these are all ordered pairs. You got 5 ordered pairs in here. You can use any of them. And if I'm doing it, I would use the smallest numbers, which is the first two. So what's your first ordered pairs? 5 and 4, 11. And what do you get?
2, 2, 6.
Your Y over your X is what?
6.
And that's equal to
3 over 3.
So this Jared is on a 50-mile bike ride. He wants to finish the ride in under 4 hours. The table shows the distance D and miles that Jared rides his bike in T hours. Find the unit rate and explain whether Jared will meet his goal based on the data. What is your X in this data?
5 times.
Yeah, that's right. So that's going to be your X. This is going to be your Y. And this is the same scenario as the one before. You just want to find the rate of change. You can pick any two. And I'm going to go with the smallest numbers. So we're going to go with 0.75, 11.25, over what? 5 and 7.5. What is that going to be? Subtract your X's, what is that?
0.25.
Yeah. And subtract your Y's. With what? 15 miles. It says that he wants to go 50 miles in 4 hours. Will he meet his goal? How many miles will he go in 4 hours?
48.
It would be 15 times 4 because he goes 15 miles in 1 hour, so he goes 60 miles in 4 hours. So does he meet his goal? Yeah, he meets his goal. I think this is the last one. The average price of milk is shown in the table. What is the rate of change for milk prices between 1978 and 2022? So what two ordered pairs are we going to use?
1978.45.
And what's your X and Y? Yeah. So in our first one, we're going to have 2022. 1450. Second one is 1978.45. What's your X's? What's your X, right?
44.
Yeah. And your Y?
3.05.
Now your X over your Y is going to be 3.05 over 44, and that is the price of it over years. And we want to find the rate of change per year, so what do we need to do? Divide by 44, and what do you get?
0.05 divided by 44. 0.06 what? 0.06931818.
Right. That is price over years. Now when you go to the grocery store and buy something, it's going to come out to the nearest hundredths place. So we need to round that to what?
0.06,
and we need to round that right there.
0.07.
Any questions on it? I got it. All right, I think I got a quiz on it.